Hi dear students, I am Naveen, lecturer in mathematics in Alpha PU College. Today we are discussing about the concept of differentiation. We already know about the concept of differentiation in previous classes and also derivations of some formulas of differentiation in 11th standard. So what is differentiation? Differentiation is the rate of change of function. Differentiation is the rate of change of function, or the rate at which the output changes with respect to input, or the rate of change of one quantity with respect to other quantity. The rate of change of one quantity with respect to other quantity. We need differentiation when the rate of change is not constant, or rate is instantaneous change. For example, when we throw a ball to some height, with respect to time, a ball rises to some height, the velocity of the ball is positive. At some height, the velocity of the ball is equal to zero. When the ball rises, the velocity of the ball is positive and the acceleration of the ball is negative. And the ball comes down, the velocity of the ball is decreases. The velocity of the ball is decreases, that means velocity is negative and the acceleration is positive with respect to time. We shall move to recall some formulas before going to the concept of chain rule or differentiation of composite functions. We know that the derivative of constant with respect to x is 0. The derivative of x with respect to x is 1. The derivative of x power n with respect to x is n into x power n minus 1. And also the derivative of x square with respect to x is 2x. And the derivative of root x with respect to x is 1 divided by 2 root x. And the derivative of log x base e is 1 by x. The derivative of e power x with respect to x is e power x. And the derivative of a power x with respect to x is a power x into log x base e. And the derivative of some trigonometric functions, like the derivative of sin x with respect to x is cos x. The derivative of cos x with respect to x is minus sin x. The derivative of tan x with respect to x is secant square x. And the derivative of secant x with respect to x is secant x into tan x. And the derivative of cot x with respect to x is minus cosecant square x. And the derivative of cosecant x, that is equal to minus cosecant x into cot x. And the derivative of 1 by x power n with respect to x is minus n divided by x power n plus 1. And the derivative of product of the constant with the function is always equal to the product of constant into the derivative of the function. derivative of f of x into g of x with respect to x that is equal to f of x into derivative of g of x with respect to x plus g of x into derivative of f of x with respect to x. This is also called as product rule. The product of the derivative of the product of the two functions is first function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. Next, the quotient of the two functions is nothing but d by dx of f of x divided by g of x is equal to g of x into derivative of f of x with respect to x. Negative sign in the middle, f of x into derivative of g of x with respect to x upon g of x whole square. That means the derivative of the derivative of quotient of the two functions is always denominator into derivative of numerator minus numerator into derivative of denominator whole divided by denominator square. Next, derivative of f of x plus or minus g of x is always derivative of f of x plus or minus derivative of g of x. Next, the derivative of some inverse trigonometric functions are the derivative of sine inverse of x with respect to x is 1 divided by square root of 1 minus x square. The derivative of cos inverse of x is minus 1 divided by square root of 1 minus x square. The derivative of tan inverse of x with respect to x is 1 divided by 1 plus x square. And the derivative of cot inverse of x is minus 1 divided by 1 plus x square. And the derivative of secant inverse of x with respect to x is 1 divided by modulus of x into square root of x square minus 1. And the derivative of cosecant inverse of x with respect to x is always minus 1 divided by modulus of square root of x square minus 1.